Welcome back to the Guski. I am Gray, and today we have another Finnish League Cup match for you. Today we have IFK Mariehamn. Not really looking forward to this. Reason being, pretty sure we're boned. Yeah. So it was kind of, of course, Roma Saha. When the fuck did you get injured? Seriously? Food poisoning, seriously. You gotta be fucking kidding me. Anyway, I did go around and kind of take a look at some stuff. I was searching for players, all that good shit. We are just really screwed. All there is to it. Because we have a lot of options available to us, we just don't have the money. That kind of sucks when your reputation outgrows your cash. I did forget to mention this. Speaking of reputation and all that good shit, when we moved up to the Finnish Premier Division, we automatically turned professional, which is good. Obviously there's some sort of rule there where, the teams there have to be professional, which means we sign players full time, all that good shit. But yeah, hence the massive increase in our, whatever you want to call it, in our reputation. However, like I said, we don't have a fucking dime to spend on anything, pretty much. So there's that. But anyway. It is what it is. Right? Anyhow, we did manage to sign... what's his name? Bachman, in between the game and the last, and Vernon decided to sign with my pod instead of us. So... yeah, there's that. So pretty much stuck with what we got now. I think that's going to be pretty much it. I don't think we're going to be able to bring anyone else in, because, like I said, we just don't have the resources to do so. But yeah. That sucks. It sucks a lot. It really does set us back quite a bit. Which then kind of puts us in a quandary, because if we don't have a squad good enough to win anything, a squad good enough to go out there, and find a way to get us some cash and all that good shit, we're not going to be able to get... It's going to be a long, long, arduous journey. We'll see how prize money and all that shit works out. I don't think... I don't think there's a whole lot of money moved around in the Irish Premier Division for your placement in the division, so that really sucks. That really hurts us too. Which means basically then we've got to win competitions and get into the Champions League in order to make money. It's pretty much the same situation I was in Ireland. However, this league's much, much better. The players here are much, much better. The talent here is a lot better. That really makes things a bit more difficult for us. So what we really need, obviously we're gonna need great performances with the squad that we have in order to get anywhere. We'll see, obviously, if that shakes out. Once again, it sucks. Like, competitions like this are great to win because they usually help out your reputation a little bit, give you a little bit of extra cash, shit like that. But, it's usually not much in them. So, like I said, I mean, we've gotta really try and find... That was a nice movement. This, I am using the 5-5-0, by the way, in case you hadn't noticed. But yeah, I mean, it's... I don't know. It's frustrating. Because, like I said, there's players there to be got, and we can't get our hands on them. Although, like I said, we got a goalkeeper coming in, but that's 2 years away, and that, once again, doesn't really bother me. We were able to sign another one of those players, Asamba, But he's a year away as well, which is fine. That's why you kind of looked to Africa. Africa had a decent amount of players that we could get our hands on. And fucking hell. Yeah, whatever. I don't fucking care anymore. I'm in the frustrated of the fucking... I hate that shit, honestly. I just... It irritates me so much. It's like, you know... Oh, and that's something, too. Like, we can't even fucking sign any coaches. I mean, I, every coach wants more money than we can offer. And they won't come down. That's something I've bitched about before. They do not fucking negotiate on this one. FM12, they negotiated quite a bit. But this game, they don't fucking negotiate at all. No one does. I mean, agents, players, you know, fucking teams, when you try and buy players, they don't, I mean, and when they try and buy from you. Oh my god, I'm going to tell you a horror story. On my Galway United career, I also have another team on there. I think I've said that like 17 times now. And it's Viking, FK. And they're, you know, a Norwegian club. I'm trying to sell this player for 5.5 million. I got a bid for about that, and I'm just really looking to make a payday off of him. You know, I'm just kind of, I mean, he's not bad. He's just, you know, one of those players that I'm, you know... Yeah, I've got better players coming in, and he's eventually going to be moved out of there. So I'm trying to like make bank on him, you know, while he's the hot topic on everyone's lips and all that shit like that. So basically, you know, I got a bid for 5.5 million for him. I was like, oh, okay, all right, that's not bad. I was like, I could, and that's really what made me decide. I was like, oh well, shit, you know, I can let go of him for that kind of money. I'm like, I'm okay with that. You know, that's not a big, oh fucking Christ. I'm about to throw my fucking mouse at the television here. I'm getting fucking pissed. I mean, this is really starting to fucking irritate me. But anyway, especially, you know, when we don't fucking foul anyone, I fucking just get everyone injured. Fuck it. Whatever, just take all my fucking players away. I don't love them fucking play. I don't fucking give a shit anymore. Anyway. You know, I'm trying to sell them, and then teams will offer, like, 4.1, you know, I had a team offer 4.5, so I'm like, oh, okay, so I'm really looking for 5.5 million out of them. I think 1 million is not bad to negotiate. I mean, there were literally a couple times where the teams offered 5 million. I was like, oh, okay, let's see if I can get another 500,000 euros out of you. And, you know, they won't negotiate at all. Like, you offer that, and like, oh, they just withdraw from negotiations. It's like, fucking seriously? I mean... I don't know. I mean, to me, that doesn't sound unreasonable. Like, when I'm bidding for players, I mean, and it's somewhere in that vicinity, I mean, you know, another 1 million or something like that, I'm like, oh, okay. All right, let's see what we can deal. You know, I mean, obviously, if they want, like, 5, 10 million more than what I bid for the player, then I'm like, okay, fuck that. But, I mean, you know, like I said, it's just, it fucking pisses me off. You know, I mean, it's... Everything is entirely on the game's terms. I mean, when it comes to fucking negotiations and contracts and shit like that. I mean, like I said, we can't even fucking sign local coaches. And I got plenty of fucking spots, too. I mean, I'm at 8 positions open in on my coaching staff. That's just on my first team. That's not even counting the under-19s. And yet, not a single fucking... I can't sign a single fucking local coach. Because they all want more fucking money than I can offer. So I went and talked to the board, said, hey, assholes, I need more money. They're like, oh, okay, we understand. Hey, look at that. Is he offsides? Okay. Someone is a fucking finisher finally. Holy shit. Don't know how to deal with that shit. But you can see also with this formation, there's a lot more... It evens out possession a little bit more. I don't know if you've noticed that. Just play, it's more enterprising than... Our 3-4-2-1-0. So I mean, I'm kind of leaning towards using this just because I think we're gonna have to be a little more open to be successful. Because I mean, the 3-4-2-1-0 works well with my Viking squad because, talent-wise, they're comparable to everyone else in the Premier Division. I'm not so sure about this. So, I mean, I think we're going to have to play a little bit more of an open game to be threatening, to be successful. Now, don't get me wrong, I love playing defensive football, but I just don't think we have enough firepower to play defensive football and be successful at it, you know? That's just me. I see us, especially with our defensive frailties from last year. You know, I kind of question that. Even while playing defensive football, we weren't very good defensively. So, yeah. And that's just the way I kind of feel about it right now. That's why I'm kind of trying this out right now. Especially against Mariehamn, one of the better clubs in Finnish football, too. But, the problem is, though, it's that sweeper position. It's an entirely weak position. I may end up changing it to just a straight back three. Just for the hell of it. I'm leaving everything as it is, just to see how that works. Oh, Christ. But anyhow. Where was I? Oh, yeah. So, as of right now, and that's something too, like, okay, like, I even with my Galway career, I just let go of fucking, was my under-19s assistant manager. I was looking to get a little bit better one. The other one had been there a long time. I was just looking for an upgrade. So I just decided not to re-sign him. I let him go and all that good shit. And then, I'm arguably the most reputable club in the fucking world. And I can't find a single fucking assistant manager in the entire fucking game that will accept the salary that I'm offering. I mean, holy fuck, like, once again, not even local boys. I mean, we're talking local guys who have no reputation in the game whatsoever. You know, that's something that's kind of irritating. It's like contract offers, and this is something I don't like. Contract offers in this one, you know, I should say contract demands in FM14 are dependent upon your club's reputation and or money. That's kind of bullshit. Because, yeah, when a fucking local guy who has no reputation whatsoever, you know, comes in and says, hey, I will ask for world-class money just the same as every other bloke. It's like, what the fuck? Like, what's the point in having them have their own reputation and shit like that if they're just going to ask for the same amount of money that some world-class guy, quote-unquote, is going to ask for? What the fuck? I mean, that's kind of bullshit. It's kind of punishing me for having success. Because, you know what, like I said, if I have to, not really stoop that low, but I have to sign him because, you know, my board doesn't accept, you know, how much money we have, or doesn't allow me to, you know, use a certain amount of money or more money on coaches, which is fine. Those are the stipulations. But then again, like I said, when there's not a single fucking coach in the game that will sign for that much, what the fuck's the point? Like, seriously, what the fuck's the point? I mean, why? There's no fucking reason for that. I mean, once again, I'm okay. All right, yeah, fine. I can't sign a world-class guy because he wants more than my club is willing to spend on coaches. Got it. No big deal. Don't really give a shit. Little frustrating, but don't really give a shit. It's fine. It's a coach. I mean, it's not going to bring down my entire fucking system. Not a big deal. But when you can't sign a single fucking coach, it's irritating. Irritating as fuck. It's like, seriously. I mean, I just want to fill these fucking spots. I mean, shit. And that's what I had to go put job adverts out, which is fine. I mean, I don't fucking mind doing that shit. But, you know, like I said, I mean, and then when you talk to the board like I did, it's like, hey, we should increase the amount that coaches are paid on our team. And they're like, yeah, we're fucking on board with that shit. And then the mountain actually doesn't change. Like, I don't know if it's a fucking glitch. I've had that happen a couple times before. But it's, I was just like, fucking seriously? I mean, it's fucking really? I mean, talk about handicapping me here. I mean, my hands are so fucking tied right now. It's fucking ridiculous. Just fucking ridiculous. I mean, just stupid. I mean, like I said, there's gotta be fucking someone somewhere. Oh my. That was about to be it for us. But I don't know. That's my rant. that's how, you know, that it's kind of like when I mentioned the other day, when you have when you have the money and you have the reputation. Oh my, did so well there except the finish. You have the reputation, you have all that shit, all of it, except the game will not give you a fucking work permit. I mean, it's shit like that. That's what's just, ugh. This shit is such a kick in the nuts. It really is. They make it so hard sometimes. And see, and these are the things that, compounded with the match engine bullshit in FM15, that would, quite honestly, you know, I mean, those are the things that irritate you to the point where you don't want to play the game. It's like, you know, if I get so handicapped, if I can't improve, I mean, you know, it's bad enough that you have to spend the time, which I don't mind, you know. You gotta spend the time, you gotta do the work, you know, you gotta win matches, increase your reputation, all that good shit. All to, you know, get a chance to sign some of these better players, and then, you know, something is there to roadblock you. Oh my, Osei, holy hell. Look at you. Look at you, Osei. I guess we figured out where we need to fucking play him. Not good at coming from midfield making those runs, but he can sure sit up there with... Oh, boy. Oh. I was hoping. But anyway, as I've said already about 16 times, it makes starting a new game really frustrating. And that's why, in my honest opinion, there needs to be some way to convert save files and update a database, you know, so that you can start, you know, where your current club is, you know, or, I mean, make the save files, you know, cross, whatever the hell you want to call it. But, you know, like I said, it fucking just irritates the fucking bejesus out of me. Such a slow start sometimes. I mean, like I said, a lot of it is due to the fact that we have a huge, giant increase in reputation. Oh my fucking hell. Are you kidding me? Fucking Jesus. Just get the fuck off the goddamn pitch. I'm pissed off now. Fuck you. Fuck you. Fuck you. Fuck you. I hate that. Fucking, oh god, I hate that. I mean, absolutely fucking pointless. Oh, and here's the real bullshit. I already fucking did that change, and it's making me fucking do it again. This thing's a fucking piece of shit. Fuck you. And that's, once again, you know, you wondered why I was getting all pissed off last time about having to fucking, play these games before friendlies. Well, this is fucking why, because you can't go in there and prevent all this fucking bullshit like this from happening. You know, chances are one of them, you know, tore a fucking hamstring and will never fucking play until, you know, end of the year. Oh my fucking god, Bachman, what are you doing? What the fuck was that? Why? What possessed you to send that all the way back to your goalkeeper? He's now going to send it to this jackass. Oh my fucking god, really? You kicked the fucking ball by yourself. Fuck! So tired of that shit. Really? I mean, just fucking really? And this, I have no words for shit like this. No fucking words for shit like this. I mean, what the fuck? I mean, come on. Just end this fucking shit. Just, I don't know. So outside of all the things that I've bitched about throughout the last 20 minutes here, this game's a lot of fun, believe it or not. I mean, aside from this fucking bullshit, I mean, come on, just come the fuck on. And one thing too I noticed in this game, you know, you can take as good a as good a care of your players as you possibly can. But I noticed that these players get injured like a motherfucker when they're on international duty. Holy shit, is it ridiculous. I mean, completely ridiculous. I actually saw that, one of my players had injured. He was only out for like a week on my Galway career. And it said this is the 7th time that he was injured on international duty. I was like, holy fuck, I don't think he's been injured 7 times on my club in the 7 years that I've fucking had him. Holy shit. Like, seriously? I mean, and yeah, it was the World Cup, and I probably lost a good 5-6 players to injury on international duty. Like, holy shit. That's one thing I'm not looking forward to. Just having fucking international players and having them get injured every week. Holy God. That was ridiculous. I never realized how often my players end injured on international duty. That was a bit irritating. And once again, what's the fucking reason for that in this game? I mean, I understand that happens with some players. Sure, whatever, but... You know, I don't see every fucking player in the world getting injured every time they go out on international duty. I mean, you know, of course, like I said, it was only a few, you know, he only had a gashed leg, so it was only like 7 to 10 days, something stupid like that. No big deal, because he was going to be on international duty at the fucking World Cup anyway, and it was going to hurt them, and I wasn't going to have him on my squad anyhow, because he was away. Which is fine, I mean, it's just, whatever. But, you know. That's a bit shocking to me. That's, you know, that sounds a bit much. I mean, like I said, I know some players who are injury prone, that shit happens too, but I mean, you know, you don't see fucking Wayne Rooney going on international duty every week and fucking getting injured. I mean, good lord. It's a bit much. Oh, there you go. Little fucking douchebag. He did not want to fucking start. Oh, yalla. What in the hell was that? I'm gonna laugh my ass off if Saarinen is the fucking cause of a fucking win here. If we steal this fucking bullshit. Of course, it won't matter, because like I said, I mean, we got fucking 3 players out injured, and probably they're all fucking likely long term. Because, hey. You know, we had Robbie last year. That was fucking bullshit. He's actually out there right now, in case you didn't notice. Yeah. He actually wanted to leave. He wasn't too happy. Nope. Just get rid of it. There you go, you dumbass. But anyway, Might not record any more of this shit today, because this is fucking irritating the hell out of me. Especially we have these fucking players gone for a long fucking time. That's gonna fucking send me over the edge. Not only can I not sign a single fucking person. And that's something too, like what good is reputation? Like, if it is reputation based, like if people fucking ask for X amount of money, you know, because of, you know, you have X amount of reputation. So what's the point in having a reputation? You know, or acquiring reputation as a small club, if, you know, everyone just asks for an egregious contract. I mean, I'm just saying. I mean, I don't know. Oh my fucking Christ. Are you kidding me? Are you fucking kidding me? I can't. Seriously? Seriously. I mean, why the fuck doesn't this happen to the other squad? I can't fucking make any changes. You go fuck yourself. I don't fucking care. I mean, seriously, what the fuck? This is fucking stupid. Fucking stupid. So fucking sick of this shit. So fucking sick of this shit. So now that you're taking players away from me, I don't have the fucking money to sign anyone. So yeah, this is just fucking screwing you. This is what this is. I mean, seriously. You know, it. All because this is all a big issue, all because the fucking game won't negotiate. That's really what it boils down to. If the game would at least negotiate, at least give you, you know, some sort of leeway, at least work with you in some sort of fucking way, issues like this wouldn't be as much of an issue. I mean, not at all. But because they hardline you and like, no, fuck you, I want this kind of money, that's all there is to it. Your hands are fucking tied. So in situations like these, you know, you're just completely fucked. Completely fucked. Whereas, once again, in the real fucking world, people compromise. I don't think they fucking understand that. I mean, you can sit here and say, oh, well, it's realistic. No, in the real fucking world, people compromise. That's the way the fucking world works. If people didn't compromise, nothing would ever fucking get done. So, what I'm saying is, this is bullshit. You know, you get fucking four players injured, although we did fucking learn something. Four players out injured, and it looks like, am I lucky enough that none of them are actually injured? I'm gonna fucking laugh my ass off if that's the fucking case. It looks that way. Did we get that fucking lucky? Good God. So, you just witnessed the most... This is like the fucking... No, never mind, I lied. Why the fuck? Oh, I know why. yeah, see, one scene. I don't even have money for a fucking physio. I can't even sign a fucking physio. Like, yeah. I mean, what kind of bullshit is that? See, yeah, 5 to 6 months with a torn calf. This is fucking bullshit. Absolute fucking bullshit. 5 weeks with a pulled hamstring. You don't even fucking want to know how I feel right now. So, yeah. So now you understand my plight. There's literally no fucking words for it. None. I mean, what the fuck? See, and that's something too. You can sit here and think, well, maybe you should have re-signed those coaches and shit that you had before. Physio, obviously, right? You know, sure, fine, whatever. But if they ask for more money than I can offer, which they did, mind you, what the fuck am I supposed to do? Who the fuck am I supposed to turn to? Like, seriously. Once again, they don't fucking compromise. You know? And what's even more bullshit is they'll ask for, like, literally 25 more euro than I can offer them. And they won't come down 25 fucking euro a week. Like, really? Really? You know, you're getting paid all that and you won't come down 25 fucking euro? Seriously? We can't make that fucking work? Once again, in the real world, people fucking compromise. That's just the way it is. Just the fucking way it is. Anyway, I'm fucking done. Hopefully next time I won't be so fucking pissed off. But I doubt that. Although we do have 2 weeks between our next match, so, yeah, whatever. I'll, see ya next time and shit. Bye!